In November 2017, one of the most complex deals in the Kenyan financial sector was concluded. The deal, fine-tuned over a period of 2 years, gave the national carrier a lifeline. The transaction involved international financiers, 11 Kenyan banks, lessors, the Kenyan government, as well as KLM, Royal Dutch Airlines.
How many seats does the Dreamliner have?
The Dreamliner? 2, 3, 4.
Almost a year later, and Kenya Airways on course, another deal is in the offing. At least, going by the statements by CEO Sebastian Mikosz, delisting from the Nairobi Securities Exchange.
This is part of the discussion that might happen during or after the PPP project. So that's a discussion that's always something to think about. Yeah, what's the added value of being listed or not being listed? But I guess that this is a more complicated and broader decision than just the partnership. The fact of being listed or not might be a consequence, but at this stage, this is not our priority.
As currently structured, Kenya Airways' majority shareholding is spread across, with Kenyan government owning 48.9%, KQ Lenders Company at 38.1%, Dutch carrier KLM with 7.8%. The remaining 5.2% is owned by other shareholders, this making a case if the carrier opts out of the stock market.
It's really an individual decision of listed shareholders, I mean the individuals, one as well as banks, as well as KLM. Should I stay as a shareholder? Should I go? What are my options of dispose the shares? This is something which is alive. So the structure of shareholding in a listed company is always something that can change any minute.
While this route is alive, Mikosz insists that at the moment, their focus is on the public-private partnership with Kenya Airports Authority. The deal is expected to give KQ Authority to manage the affairs of the Jomo Kenyatta International Airport, JKIA, a much-needed leverage in the competitive aviation industry.
This public-private partnership is not used in any other country, so we can have a system in which we have synergy between assets, but it doesn't mean that we're copying exactly the other models.
Back at the Pride Center, KQ's head office, the CEO has his work cut out, a dream that he says is achievable by any means necessary.
My dream would be really to have 100 destinations, 150 aircraft, and a profitable airline, and whatever it takes to achieve it, that's my dream.
In the meantime, the over 80,000 shareholders of the national carrier will begin to find out what the future holds for them.
The shareholding structure of this airline might once again change depending on whether or not KQ is delisted from the Nairobi Securities Exchange following the signing of a public-private partnership agreement between KQ and KAA expected by the end of the year. Mombi Waroe, Citizen TV, at the KQ headquarters in Nairobi.